If you're working with a headless website builder like Prismic, you're probably going to create a lot of slices or page sections that you'll then use to build your pages. Content teams need lots of different components in order to create interesting, dynamic websites. That means you, the developer, get to create those slices for them to use. You can create a single page type, build out a dozen or so of these big full-width components, and then your content team can go and build as many pages as they need. This is a win-win. It gives your content team a ton of flexibility without needing to pull in a developer for each new page. But if not done right, all of those components can actually cause performance issues. See, by default, you're forcing your visitors to download code for each and every potential slice. The more slices in your project, the bigger the bundle for each page. Until everything's loaded, your elements might not be interactive, your content might not be visible, and it might even hurt your search engine ranking. We can avoid all of these issues by only loading the slices that a page is using. Most likely, you're not using every slice on every page. You might be using, let's say, 3 out of the 15 slices in your project on a certain page. We can stop our framework from bundling the code for all of the slices and let the browser only fetch the code that it needs for the slices that are on that page. Now the site loads and becomes interactive faster, and Google isn't going to penalize our search rankings. The best part is that enabling lazy loading only takes some small changes to our code. Hey, I'm Alex from Prismic, and I'm going to show you how to dynamically load only the slices you need in any Next, Nuxt, or other Reactor View website. Let's get into it. All right, so let's take a look at this Next.js demo project I have here. We're importing our slices in the standard React way, like cover from slices cover, and then we map each component to its slice type in this object. And then here in our slice zone, we're hard coding an array that lets the slice zone know which slice to render and in what order. Normally that data would be coming in from your CMS and would have all of the text and image content along with it, but for this demo, we're hard coding and keeping it simple. So if I take a look at this page over in our browser, I can see that these slices are rendering just fine. I got my cover slice, I have my feature slice, and then I have my number slice down here. So each of those slices are coming in, and it works, but if we open our network tab, we reload the page, we'll see that we have our eager.js. This is our page. We are coming in at 173 KB on that main page. Not terrible, but it could be a lot better. We are pulling in each and every single slice. So I can show that that number won't actually change. If I comment out a couple of these slices, we only have our cover slice now. Let's reload the page and see our eager.js. Still 173, but we only have the one slice. That's because we are still importing features and numbers here. We didn't get rid of those. Next is still going to bundle those up and ship those along to the client. That doesn't make sense. That's not a great way to do this, right? But it doesn't know any better. We're not telling it to do anything different. Let's do that. Let's tell it something different. Let's tell it to only load in the slices that we need. Over here in our dynamic page, we have just that. So as you can see here, we are importing components in a different way compared to Eager. This is kind of the standard React way, right? Here, we're using something called Next Dynamic, right here at the top. Import dynamic from Next Dynamic. And Next Dynamic takes a function. So we are calling dynamic, and we are passing it a arrow function, and we then tell it to import slices cover lazy. While this is called cover lazy, there's nothing you actually have to do in your component. We just changed it there for the demo purposes. So we see we have our components, same kind of object, same thing where you're mapping keys to values, but now instead of that component coming in immediately, it comes in through dynamic. If you come down here, we see the same exact slice zone we had before, but if we come over here to dynamic, we're gonna see something different in our network tab. Let's give a refresh and see that we get a lot more things coming in than with our eager loading, right? We're seeing a lot more files here. So we need to look for dynamic, because that's the name of our page. Dynamic's coming in at 79 KB now, a good deal smaller than our other one. But we also see some other things. We see our slice numbers lazy, our slice features lazy, and our slice cover lazy. Now, that's because they're each being called in as their own little JavaScript bundle. When we don't need them, they don't get called in. So let's do the same thing that we did before. I'm going to comment out features and numbers, just like that, save, and I'm going to hit refresh. And now we still see slices cover lazy because next dynamic new to go and get that and add that bundle. But when we look at dynamic, it stays the same, still around 79, but nothing else is here. So overall, we're saving a lot and having to download a lot less code, having to run a lot less JavaScript because we are dynamically loading the only slice that we actually used. If we bring them back, those other slices will come back just as expected. So if you have a big library of lots of slices, it's awesome because your content editors can use all those to build out really great pages, but you don't want to get caught sending that big, big bundle with everything. So using Next Dynamic really helps you out there. Now, a big bundle might not seem like a big deal for one page, but if you're using Next.js's dynamic routes, then that one page file could potentially be what dozens or hundreds of different pages actually load and run on. So you want to make sure each of those pages is as small as possible. You don't want them all having the same big size, sharing one big bundle. You want each of them as trim as you can get them. So if I build for production, I can see that Eager is coming in at 24 and our dynamic page is coming in at 3.7. So the cool thing is that if I go ahead and disable JavaScript and reload this page, we'll see that we don't pull in any of those slices. We don't pull in really anything, right? We're not running any JavaScript. But look, all of my content is still here. I'll refresh again just to show. It's all still here. Next.js is statically building this HTML and then hydrating over it with our JavaScript. But if our JavaScript doesn't load for whatever reason, we're still getting these slices. So there's nothing lost. There's no downside to this. There's another method we can use in React called React Lazy. It creates a similar outcome to Next Dynamic, but it uses React's native helper instead. So because we want to use Next Dynamic when we're in a Next.js app, here I have just a Vite React app. You can use a Create React app. Anything that's running React 18 is going to have this built in. So here we see we have to import nothing new at the top, like we don't have to import Next Dynamic or anything. We're just importing React, and then we're using React.lazy pretty much the same way that we were using Next Dynamic in our other example. Down here, we can see we have our slices. Same thing, just swapping out Dynamic for React.lazy in this example. Now, if we go over to our browser, we see that we have pretty much the same result, but this one's being run through Vite with React, and we can see we have our lazy JSX coming in at about 5.8 KB, and then we see we have cover lazy, features lazy, and numbers all coming in separately at a big KB here, but that'll get trimmed down once we go to production. The main part that we want to take away from this is that it's splitting out the slices so that if we only ship a couple of slices, or say if you have your 20 slices in your whole library, if you're only shipping two, it's only going to ship the ones that you actually use. Here's cover lazy. We don't see numbers. We don't see anything else anymore because React Lazy is taking care of those and only importing them when we need it. So how do you decide which one to use? Next Dynamic, React Lazy, something else? As a rule, if your framework has a helper for lazy loading just built in, use that. They can generally provide better outcomes because they can hook into framework-specific optimizations. For Next.js, always use Next Dynamic. React Lazy does not inject the JavaScript bundles for the rendered components in that initial HTML. For Nuxt, enable Nuxt components and use the word lazy as a prefix in front of the component you want to lazy load. If your framework doesn't have a built-in lazy loading solution, remember that React, Vue, and even Svelte have solutions here. For React, use React Lazy like we demonstrated. For Vue, when you go to define your component object, use an arrow function that returns an import. Awesome. We learned how to use Next Dynamic to make our Next.js sites light and speedy. We learned how to use React Lazy to lazy load components in any React app. We even touched on how to lazy load components in Nuxt and Vue apps. So we see that when loaded correctly, slices make for full flexibility without any performance downsides. That means happy content teams and happy developer teams. Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Hey, Alex here. If you enjoyed that video, don't forget to leave a like. And if you have a question, we're here for you in the comments section below. We're putting out videos regularly, and we premiere them with a live Q&A in the chat. Subscribe so you don't miss the next one.